Hi, everybody. Welcome to 10-Minute Tips from OSINT Curious. I'm Micah Hoffman, and today I'm going to show you the web developer tools in Google Chrome and Firefox. Now, from an OSINT perspective, many times we care about what's shown on a page, but we also care about some of the things that are inside of the page, places that it pulls images from, JavaScript from, things that are found in the source code and other places. And the developer tools inside of our browsers already help us do that. You just have to enable it. So let's go ahead and dive right in. I'm going to use a website that many of you know about. It's called CNN.com for most of the work that I'm doing. So going to CNN.com in the first browser, Firefox, we see a bunch of information being pulled up here on the page. And if you're doing OSINT, yeah, you're going to probably scrape these, or if you're using Chrome, you're going to be putting it into Hunchly. Let's go ahead and enable the developer tools and just see what kind of extra information we can find. Now, you can enable the developer tools several ways. The first is hitting the F12 key if you have that on your keyboard. Or in Firefox, go up to Pancake menu here and go down to Web Developer, and then toggle Tools, or of course, Control-Shift-I. Now, I've made this a little bit bigger here just for readability. You can click and drag this up and down to adjust it to the size of your screen. When we first get into the developer tools, we can see a bunch of information here. These are the different features, the inspector, console, debugger, blah, blah, blah. Each of these does a different thing to allow you to dissect what the page is doing and what content is on it. For instance, the inspector allows us to move our mouse over different parts of the page here and highlight where that section is. So we can see exactly what the HTML or JavaScript on the page in a certain section does. That's pretty cool. One of the things that I really want to point out for our purposes here is this network tab. The network tab will allow us to see all of the different requests that a web page is making. It'll show us where it's pulling the images from, JavaScript, other things, what parameters it's submitting to the different websites. And in fact, right now, I don't have any ad blockers. This is just a plain version of Firefox here. I don't have any ad blockers or tracker blockers installed here. And you can see that while I'm talking to you, my web browser is making requests out to data.cnn.com, image2.pubmatic, ade.googlesyndication.com, pubmatic. So it's making these requests. I'm not doing anything. This can be very important to us in our investigations to see where the different websites pull images from, what they're connected to, as that can give you data that you need. And if we scroll down the page, as we scroll down, it will probably load more images and other things. And you can see here, we're getting more information. Now, we can filter this if we're not interested in all of the data here. You see this all HTML, CSS, JavaScript, etc. We can only look at where the images are being pulled from. And you can see that here we have just GIFs. Or we can do XHRs, which are XML HTTP requests. That's some type of scripting mechanism in your browser requesting different pages and resources. We can turn that on and see what's being requested that way as well. Now, this can again be very important to you, but you have to enable it. Again, hitting the F12 key or enabling the developer tools. Now, if we go over to the Google Chrome browser and we go to that same page, we can see that it's the developer tools are in a little different place. Now, again, I have no ad blockers here or whatever. We can hit the F12 key if we wanted, or we can go over to the little snowman, three dots here, and go down to more tools and developer tools. And again, Control-Shift-I actually does it as well. Okay. Now, in Google Chrome, you can see that the developer tools are on the right-hand side of the screen. I would imagine this is because in many laptops and displays, we have wider screens than taller screens. Personally, I like this at the bottom of my web page. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the little three dots here underneath of the three dots there. and I'm going to change the dock side to the bottom, dock to the bottom. And that allows me to make it look very similar to what I saw on Firefox. And again, we have elements, we can highlight different sections of the page, see what the HTML source is. Now in Google Chrome, when you hit the network button, we get a similar type of view. Let's go ahead and enable all of them. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger. We get a similar type of view as far as what resources this browser is requesting right now. And as you can see, pixel.gif from moatads.com. We have this other tracker here, and a whole bunch of other things are being loaded. And we see what is actually requesting that, whether it's Tribal Fusion or bid switch code in the page. But you probably noticed that something's missing here, right? What domains are we reaching out to? If I switch back to Firefox, we see this domain, Image 6 PubMatic, Amazon Ad System. But you look over here, we don't see that in any of these columns. We have the name, status, type. To add that domain, we have to right-click on one of these category heads and select domain. Now we can see what domains are actually being requested, or what domains we're requesting information from. There you go. So this can help you understand, again, what different types of resources are being requested from the different websites you visit. All right. Now, you can do this in other web browsers as well. If you do, you can go to Internet Explorer. Let's go to our page, cnn.com. And again, here, I'm just going to hit the F12 button, and we've got the developer tools popping up there. And it's a little bit different formatted, a little slower, a little different formatted. But you see, we have the exact same type of information showing up. Well, that's my OSINT tip for this session. Thanks for listening in, and stay OSINT curious.